Hello everybody, in this video I will present the example déverrouille, that means unlock in French. So the idea is to present an illustration of in-app authentication and to handle success or problems in the application. So let's start the application. So here I can type on unlock. And what I will do is first try to cancel, and then I get the information that authentication failed. Okay, then I can retry again, and since I have Touch ID and fingerprints are activated, I must do the fingerprint stuff to access the information, which is here the case. Everything is okay. Let's now try another terminal that only has a code, no touch ID. So here I press unlock and I have to enter my code to get the secret. Now let's try on the same terminal as previously, but meanwhile I have deactivated the code. So I can use my terminal without typing any code. So I start the application, and when I do the unlock, the evaluation of the policy I selected is impossible because there is no authentication, and then I get this message. So let's have a look on the view controller of this application, because everything is in the view controller. So here, the first important thing is to import the framework local authentication. Okay. And here, this is the view did load. I absolutely don't present again and again how to build a view. You know that perfectly. So you can mimic the view if you want to reproduce my example. What's important is that here, in my button, I will refer to a method that is called unlock. That's all. So when I do the unlock, I will activate authentication. So here I create a context and I decide that authentication type will be owner authentication. I could use this constant for biometric only, and then it will not work, it will fail on a terminal that doesn't have a touch ID or other biometric-like mechanisms. Then I have a variable, it's a pointer, it's the way they want to restitute the values for you. Then I will check if the authentication policy I have selected is available on the terminal. If it's not available, then I will scream. Otherwise, I will ask for the evaluation of the authentication policy. So I required for a reason, and then I said, when replying, you will call handle unlock, and if you call handle unlock, then it will be it will receive the information whether the authentication has failed or not. I have here a service method that display error message. It's mainly interesting because here you have a list of useful constants and their signification here. Okay, so it's a way to provide a comprehensive error message. Here you have a method show alert that is used in the previous method tour. Okay, it creates the alert controller, etc., etc. So this is something you already know. And you have the handle unlock method, so with the boolean and the error. It's the prototype you must respect. It could have been provided online with a block as well, as usual with handlers. Okay, and here, according to the OK parameter, either you display the secret, okay, or you display an error message here, providing the information you get at this stage as an information to explain what occurred and why the authentication did fail. So, easy, isn't it? This might be a must for your applications, essentially if you are using some touchy features or some touchy data or some touchy action within a company or whatever. Okay, and of course, it doesn't mean that you just allow display or not of some information. It has to go also with an appropriate encoding of the information in a way that if you force your user to authenticate, to do some action, access some information, for example, and this information is stored clearly in the terminal, it's useless. Then remind that if you want to do security, you have to do it from one hand to the other hand. Thank you for your attention. See you later.